Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Critical Reactions with your host, Brian. We're going to wrap up today with a special selection, which is where one of you tell me exactly what it is I need to check out. Today's special selection comes at us from Brian. Hey, Brian, hope things are going well for you. I've linked for you today a band called Counterparts. They're a melodic hardcore band from Ontario, Canada, and I'm curious to hear your thoughts on the group. Cheers. All right, let's dive into this. Melodic hardcore sounds interesting to me. Hardcore is kind of an abrasive, simple genre. I don't mind checking out a melodic take on it. So let's dive into the track Outliers, see what Counterpoints bring into the table. Music has a nice mix of positive and negative qualities to it, emotionally. It's not totally uplifting, but it's not sorrowful either. It's somewhere in the middle. And see right there, all that aggression just kind of had an upturn coming out of our breakdown. Hopefulness coming through in the music as well. I was not expecting Queens. Yeah, that probably goes into another track there. Interesting. It's pretty much what I was expecting, given the hardcore side. And the melodic part to me is short. Sparse, I think, is the word I want there. It could be a bit more melodic, but as far as hardcore goes, I think this appeals to me more than most, which is a pretty big step up, at least from what I picture hardcore to be. Through that lens, I want to look at a couple of things, primarily before we hit the lyrics. One is going to be the rhythmic elements. There are several of these sections that are texture-based and rhythmic based, where the instruments are pairing well, hitting the same accents as the drums. Now, even in the sections that have a melodic component, this is typically the foundation, though it also becomes the spotlit element in sections such as the breakdown, where the rhythmic and textural elements are what the section is about. But in the foundational sections, we tend to have a guitar, the bass, and the drums laying down this rhythmic textural thing, with occasionally a guitar over it providing some sort of melodic riffage, sometimes linear, interestingly, on top of it. And then, of course, we have the vocals, and we'll get to them in a moment. When it comes to the melodic aspect of the track, I find it most interesting that they are linear. We don't have riffs here, at least none that I heard that I could say is, you know, one bar or two bars and is repeated. Everything feels linear. It's non-cyclical. And what's even more interesting is that we might have our left guitar doing this idea, and they have a little bit of a flow and some movement to it, and then out of nowhere a right guitar will come in. It'll be the same guitar. I don't think it is the second guitarist. I think it is the same guitar as this one, just recording a second track. It's the same tone on the guitar, and they'll harmonize with it. Or one very specific point in the song, somewhere about the halfway point, we heard I guess we could call it a counterpoint. It was like for three beats, four beats. It was really short, but it was a second idea against our primary. I would like to hear more of that. I think this works really well as a hardcore track that has melodic elements to it. But as far as being a melodic hardcore track, I'm kind of missing the melody. I'm missing some melodic strength, I think is what I'm asking for here. And that's not to say that Counterparts needs to do that. It's just that if I were to dig into the genre, I would look for something that leans a little more on the melodic side than the hardcore side, whereas this does the opposite. We do have the chorus, though, which has a melodic moving guitar underneath the between the vocals and the foundation, pretty much through the entire section. And I enjoyed this part the most, I think. But I think what also kind of detracts my experience on the song, and this is going to be a little bit more subjective, is going to be the vocals. Not because they're bad, they're just not my cup of tea. As I've mentioned in the past, when it comes to harshes, I prefer variety, whether pairing them against cleans or having a variety of harshes at your disposal. And this follows in line with early metalcore and most hardcore in that the vocalist has a pitch, they have a sound that they produce very well, that they have a lot of practice doing, and it probably comes to them naturally as well. And that's what they hit. And this dude has that one pitch, that one sound, and that's what all of the lyrics are. And it just becomes too repetitive for my ears. It is also in the spotlight. When it comes to something like black metal and even some death metal, the vocals tend to get pushed into the mix. They're easier to ignore, but here they're put in the spotlight, much like any mainstream music. And they just can't carry the song. They're not interesting enough to my ears because it is a texture and a rhythm, not a melody. And so the song, every time I'd go to listen to something else, consistently said, "Hey, have you actually heard what those lyricists is doing? They're in the spotlight, you know, you should probably check them out." Okay, I'll go check. No, they're doing the same thing, and I'll focus over here, and the song will pull my attention back to the vocals. They're so prominent in the mix. It's difficult not to hear what they're doing, but they're not doing anything of interest past the opening. One of the things that I enjoy about rap, which is also a textural and rhythmic vocal delivery format, is that there is typically a sort of complexity to it all, whether it's in the wordsmithing itself and the complexity of the linguistic element, or it's in the complexity of the rhythmic technicalities. A lot of harsh vocalists don't go for either of those. Primarily, one, because the vocals, the lyrics themselves tend to be obscured by the technique. And that happened here as well. I couldn't make out most of the words, so I can't appreciate the vocals, or sorry, the lyrics on a first listen. And there was no rhythmic complexity. In fact, most of the rhythms were pretty repetitive. He would find a rhythmic pattern he enjoyed. Maybe it was two bars long and stick with it over and over, much like a drum pattern. In fact, that's kind of what the vocals feel like to me, is that they should have been a pulse as a foundational aspect of the song. So there's nothing wrong with how this was created. Hardcore does this all the time. Hardcore has a massive fan base. It's just not my cup of tea because it is what it does. You know, the genre as a whole doesn't appeal to me because of how it tends to spotlight some of the most stagnant elements of the track. And that's exactly what happened here. So this isn't a criticism about this track or even this band. It's more of just why I can't connect or have difficulty connecting with the genre as a whole. But I did enjoy the melodic components to this. I found the worst part of the track is probably what people look forward to, which is the bridge, the breakdown. The production just wasn't there for it. It was too compressed, so the breakdown, which should have been a high point of the track, felt no different than any of the other rhythmic textual foundations. We just didn't have a melodic element to elevate it. It was just our foundation. So, I find I'm in an odd spot for this track because from an objective level, this is a fine track. It does what the genre does well. It has a little bit of melody in there for people who don't like the pure texture-based hardcore. And I'm sure it has a bunch of fans because it feels very iterative for the genre. But on a subjective read, I have such a hard time connecting with this on any level because it is so far outside the realms of what I enjoy. And I don't have a lot of experience with it to appreciate it from an artistic perspective. It, you know, this happened with a lot of genres. I bring up black metal because it's the most prolific on the channel. I had a very hard time appreciating it in the beginning. And while I still don't like it as a genre, I can appreciate it better because I understand what it does, having listened to hundreds of tracks by now. And that's, I think, where I'm at with hardcore. Or at least this particular branch of hardcore, is that I'm still in the beginning. I'm not a huge fan of what it sounds like, but I don't have enough experience with it to have an appreciation for what they're doing, even within their genre. Was there something else? Oh, yes. There was the ending. I greatly enjoyed this. We had vocal work, clean vocal work come in. It probably could have used a little bit of punch in the production, but honestly, I think everything could have used a little bit of punch in the production. The song overall feels a bit flat to me, which doesn't help in the breakdown especially. But we added new melody that worked against the guitars and created a counterpoint. And this is what I would want to hear more of if I was listening to this type of music casually. Melodic hardcore with clean vocals primarily, and harshes to punctuate specific phrases, to give emphasis to specific words, maybe even or phrases, because the music itself doesn't have enough of melodic quality for my tastes. And the vocals here really added to it. And I really appreciate what they did here. And I wish we would have heard more of this, given that we had 75% of this track is harsh vocals. I was not expecting this at all. I really figured they were going to go harsh vocals to the end, and then knowing that they have cleans really made me wish we had done a bit more back and forth, maybe had cleans during the chorus or something. But again, all of this comes at it from both a subjective view of my tastes in music and an objective view of the track's balance in a vacuum. This track is also part of an album, and it could be that it balances the album. Maybe the album has a bit more weight towards clean vocals, and this is the heavy track on the album. So it's really difficult to gauge that in that capacity, because while I am looking at a single track that can be listened to alone, it is also part of a larger work, and you have to view it from both perspectives. That's all my thoughts on here. Let's hit some lyrics. Now see, the lyrics here are hyper angsty, and it fits the predominant harsh vocal usage very well. Musically, I still wish it had a little bit of contrast to it, but at least pairing the themes of the lyrics to the lyric delivery makes sense to me now. The song is about feeling isolated from not only your little world around you, you know, your friends, your family, you know, the people directly in you, but also feeling isolated in the world at large. It is an isolation on every level, so much so that this person feels they are an outlier and don't belong here. But they also see existing in this isolation as pain, but necessary, because it gives them truth. And they seem to have a... It's weird because some lines make them appear that they view themselves through a superiority, that they don't shield their eyes and they're no longer blind to mankind, as stated in the chorus. But in other lines, they almost seem to say that I'm nobody. He says, I'm an outcast. Don't look for me in the clouds. When I'm beneath you, nowhere to be found. You know, I'm a no one. But I'm also better than everyone. I've seen the truth, and it causes me pain, and it sucks. And life is just a lot of hurt because of that. But I don't know, it's kind of all over the place. We also have this stanza right here, right before our outro, that I keep drawing myself back to. It says, I've grown sick of the sound of my heartbeat while the whole world breathes in unison. Speaking about a lack of isolation for everyone else in the world, and him alone with only the sound of his heartbeat, he says, I'm sick of that. He says, but my lungs are my shield to reject the world around me. Now, taking it, this is possibly the voice of our vocalist and not necessarily a character in the story of the song. It's possible that this is to say that I am in isolation, but despite that, I still speak truth, and I use my lungs to do that. And that truth that I speak is what isolates me. He says, my lungs are my shield to reject the world around. So he says what he feels. People don't like that. They leave him alone. And that's why he's an outcast. Our final stanza even sort of solidifies this a bit. He says, I am what I am, and I am an outcast. This is the root of my isolation. Earlier, we see a variation of this. It says, human hatred is my second nature. It's the root of my isolation. So he hates everything. He sings about hating everything. He's submerged in apathy, which shows up a few lines later. He says, it becomes hard to care and I'm nothing. And so he's just this person that nobody wants to be around. But he still seems to want to scream about how lonely he is, despite the fact that he is the cause of his loneliness. A lot of self-work, seeing a therapist, healing the mind, healing the heart, getting a better perspective on life would aid a lot of this. And instead, he just digs into it deeper. He digs his heels into the ground and says, this is where I'm staying. I'm not going anywhere. I will continue to I will continue to sing about how much I hate the world and how sick I am of being here. And if that makes me an outcast, fine. And I just, at the beginning, I had sympathy for this dude, you know? He feels separated from everyone. And, you know, feels that life is suffering because of this. But by the end of it, it's his fault. All he has to do is take a step towards self-care and he wouldn't be in this place anymore. And I don't know when this track came out. I don't have a date for this album, and I'm not going to go look it up because we're about to wrap this up. But I really hope that if these are words of our vocalist and not a character in a story or anything like that, I really hope that they have found a way to heal since this song came out, since they wrote these lyrics at least. Because this is just not a healthy state of mind to be in. And I do kind of hope it's just like a character in a story and that this isn't basically the voice of the vocalist, because it breaks my heart. It does. 2013. So it's a decade old. I hope he's found some love since then. Self-love. Some introspection too. Those are my thoughts on Outlier by Counterparts. Let me know your thoughts, perspectives, ideas, all down in the comment section. Above that, in the description box, you can find a link to Linktree. Takes you to my music, Discord server, ways to support the channel, so much more. It's just a ton of stuff in there. Go ahead and check it out. Above that, if you could, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. I greatly appreciate all three of those. That wraps it up for today. We'll be back tomorrow. What are we going to do tomorrow? Oh, yeah. We're going to wrap this up. Oh, geez. Sometimes I forget what day it is, and I'm just like on autopilot. I don't know what tomorrow is. But yeah, it's Friday. We're not going to do the Wild Shifts theme tomorrow. We're going to save that for Monday. We're going to do two special selections. So drop by for that. Until next time, remember to be critical, not cynical, of the music you listen to, and have a fantastic morning, afternoon, or evening, whenever you choose to watch my videos.